Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. My name is Raj Dham. I am originally from Assam, but I've been in Bangalore for the last 20 years. So I'm pretty much an honorary Connecticut, and I love the Bangalore football club. I love football. I look like one, but that's what I'm. All right, so I'm here to talk to you on a fashion project, which is also profitable, called Outsell. We are trying to change how sales guys have customer conversations. And we are on our way to do that. So I'm not going to, you know, kind of take you through all of this slide, but here's the thing. I'm just giving you a background to what has happened over the last 20 years. 20 years ago, the sales guy had a lot of power, but one thing fundamentally changed that completely. Yeah. And what's that? That's the internet, right? Because today, everything that you want to buy, you probably researched before you even step into a shop to buy an automobile or anything of that sort. And the same thing happens in both B2B and B2C cases. So now if you're going to be a B2B sales executive, you'd see that there's a committee buying process that happens in large enterprise, right? You go service multiple departments, which means that typically there are two things are happening. So the control is shifting to the buyer than what the sales guy was able to offer before. Now, therefore, what is the overall problem that's happening in the industry? 80% of the sales reps in the manufacturing industry struggle with three things. Number one, they struggle with the range, because the company would have invested in R&D for the high value items and they are not able to articulate the benefits. And they struggle to justify pricing. Somebody talked about differentiator. Why should the price of this X cost more than Y? You'll find sales guys often find it difficult to justify that. And why is this happening? Because training, in effect, what was again happening 20 years ago is now ineffective today. And these are some of the reasons, right? Because 80% of the learning is, so there's a German scientist called Ebbinghaus, Herbert Ebbinghaus, who clearly proved that anything you learn, if you don't reinforce that learning, you will forget this within 3 weeks. So learning is forgotten. We have millennials in the sales force who learn completely differently than what people would have learned earlier. If there is no practice, content itself sometimes is boring. You have been given 50 slide decks and PDFs which nobody reads. So therefore the result of that is the sales guy doesn't have trust, okay, cannot differentiate, he misses sales opportunities. Anybody in sales here would understand that they miss pipeline accuracy, which means the forecasting is wrong, and that's a huge problem from the CSO downwards. Okay, so if this was the problem, this is our solution. And what we basically say is never have a bad meeting. How? So, just a broad description of what Outsell is. We're a multiple award-winning sales enablement company for sales and also customer service reps. A lot of customer service reps carry a tablet. What we basically do is to make sure that new hire onboarding can happen, people can know product knowledge and sales skills on the go through both web and mobile device, and across all the customer's life cycle. Every meeting that you have with multiple stakeholders in an enterprise, you've got to make sure that you're covered with your knowledge and you're able with your content that you can actually showcase to win a deal. Okay, so market size, sales enablement, even as a word, is a new word. As a technology, it's a combination of multiple things. Overall, we're talking about a $7 billion market, but this is primarily the sales training technology and does not cover sales analytics and the CRM of the world. I'm just talking about us. Currently, we're focused in the medtech space. In medtech space, we're talking about 500 companies, which is our TAM. Out of this, the kind of companies that would probably need our services and products are 200. We feel that we can right away address up to 50 companies in this space. That's where we are. Of course, we've chosen to be very sector focused. Although as a sales training technology or enablement technology, we are sector agnostic. We can go to any sector. But it's very important that you've got to be a king of the village instead of being just a mayor of the town, right? So we've got to make sure that we own market share in one space before we go into the other one. Okay, and BFSI is second, where we go next. Our competitors largely are in US at this point of time. A couple of them, like Mindtical, is also in India. These are companies that have raised a lot of money. They are focused on sales enablement technology, just like us. Our secondary competition are also people who are LMS guys, like if any of you know SuccessFactors by SAP and so on and so forth. Those are also our secondary competition, because sometimes there's a legacy technology that we need to disrupt and take them out for us to be in within a company. Okay, so what are the differentiators, right? We basically follow a philosophy called MAD, which is mechanics, aesthetics, and dynamics, right from the product design to the narrative to how the customer is going to actually use it. And we have proof of the pudding. So if you look at people like Sarah, Span, Puma, Minax, this is some of the customers that we had. We have almost had 80% plus adoption ratio of voluntarily, because the biggest problem in technology is, you know, you can give it to somebody but they don't use it. And that's a problem that we've been able to solve as compared to our large population. So essentially, this is what we offer: learning, content, and data. I'm not getting into all of these. These are functional learning within an organization. But this is all the content that is managed and then put together for people to show and tell, the sales guys. So they do not need to focus on the memory only. Data. You know, then you can get a lot of data-driven decisions on what content you're producing. So marketing knows what content they're producing is actually working in the field. Our business model is largely, the way we make money is we instead have a SaaS model sales. We also have some solutions and setup fee that we offer on top of it. And you know, we basically are developing the product and we're selling the product. That's the primary go-to-market that we have. This is the team. I come from Dell. Miraj is from Goldman Sachs, and Varun, of course, is from TCS. You know, while Miraj look for business and operations, Varun look for technology. We have no funding yet. We are bootstrap, but we are zero debt. This year we have done about 1.25 CR. We close March at that number. We have achieved operational profitability at 75 lakhs, and we were probably hoping to touch 3 crores, $500,000 by next year. What we basically are looking from you is, if you know people in medtech or if you know anybody in manufacturing, you'll be doing a great favor to us and them if you refer us. And any feedback on our product, on our go-to-market, very happy to, you know, get that ready. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That's my time.
So, any questions or clarifications required?
Do you work with partners?
Yes, you know, we are just setting up a partner called Vanguard Diagnostics in Gurgaon. They are a large diagnostics company. And we also have another partner from Cochin who come from the medtech space. Yes, we also work with partners.
Do you work with pharma companies?
As I said, medtech, not pharma yet. We are only talking to people who make medical devices and equipment, like, you know, hospital companies. Yeah, G, Philips are on the top end. You have, you know, a whole bunch of guys in the middle end and whatever.
How large is the team?
We are about 8 of us right now, 7 of us in Bangalore, 1 in Bombay.
So including the founders?
Yeah, that's correct.
Including the 3 founders.
Yeah, that's correct.
Could you grab the MSME sector?
That's exactly where, not MSME for us to be relevant to the organization, we need about at least 40 plus. So we are ideally define our market as an ICP. Somebody who is 50 to 150 sales guys out in the field, and that's the guy who, you know, really has needs us, because he has his first sales force and he cannot, you know, train or have content relevant to them all the time.
So how do you do the onboarding of clients in terms of training? SaaS, that could be one of the challenges for sales people on the field. Okay, so customers, how do you solve the problem?
When you say onboarding, do you mean new
training,
hires?
Training. For the customer who's using a product, the sales guy on the field,
right,
who's supposed to be expected to enter data when he meets, when he has a meeting.
Right.
Most of them, usually on the ground, don't do it.
Right.
Is there some mechanism you address the problem?
Yes. So just to rearrange your question, what you're talking about is extremely relevant in a CRM company, where he is going for a field activity company.
Okay.
So where he is going and he's plugging his daily route and all that. That's a massive problem in the CRM industry. In fact, there are companies trying to solve this problem, you know, just like so. For us, the sales guy has largely access and learning. So the only data that we collect from him is feedback, which is minute as compared to what a CRM company has to do. So he has to probably finish a module and then he has to just probably just find, which is his touch. So we really don't have a problem with that.
It's not the CRM.
It's not a CRM component here. It's enablement in the terms of, so effectively this entire technology has 3 parts. We call it the CTC philosophy, which is content. So you have access to content. Think of it like a much advanced Google Drive, where you have search, analytics capability, everything over that. And then there is a learning engine, like an LMS functionality, where you're able to see content and then ask quizzes and get a certification. So get people to any kind of certifications that need to be done for people to go to the field. And then there's a communication. So I'm able to communicate to people in a group messaging. And so this is what we call a CTC.
So I have a question. So why MedTech, why not FMCG? And FMCG sales is more in the United States.
Yes, great question. Thank you for that. While a couple of our competition are focused on FMCG, if you look at FMCG, the key thing is process knowledge, also to some extent product knowledge. So in the sense, process knowledge, I know for a fact that large enterprises, like you mentioned, P&G, you know, Dabur, they have a process, 7 steps to complete when you are in a Kirana shop, right? So have you checked with your merchandise on display? You know, have you not interrupted the guy if you were stocking something? So this process is very, very important. Sometimes if you are going to sell a little higher value product or a new design product, then you've got to make sure that you transfer that knowledge to that guy, right? So that's great. For us, the reason why we choose manufacturing is because of also the competences that we have as a team, which is, I come from Dell. I was looking at SMB programs at Dell, you know, so I have a fair understanding of how SMBs operate and how manufacturing companies operate, as compared to my knowledge of FMCG. Yeah, so we might as well get a, you know, space here and get more, you know, revenue and market share and then move to FMCG. However, if you know an FMCG company, I'm very happy to help because they will need us. Yeah.
Okay, sorry, one other question.
No more questions. Thank you.